All right, welcome. For those of you who are already here, we're going to get started in a few minutes, waiting for others to arrive. The paint colors that we'll be using today are white, black, red, yellow, and blue. Purple, if you'd like. Hey, James. And if you don't have paint or canvas or brushes, that is totally fine. You can do this on paper. You can do it on a paper plate. You can do it on a paper bag. You can use crayons, you can use colored pencils, highlighters, whatever you've got around the house. We will make it happen. And in case this is your first live video experience, there is a delay of several seconds. So if you have a question or a comment, I'm not going to see it right away. It'll take me a few seconds to respond. So once again, welcome. We'll get started in a few minutes. We want everybody to get here and get settled. Take a look at our materials list, set up your art area, get your snacks ready, your drinks ready, and we'll get started in a few minutes. I'm sure if Marissa is watching, Marissa could tell you more about how to donate directly to Jana Marie Foundation. They would definitely appreciate the help. I know that one of their bigger fundraisers had to be canceled. So yes, if you'd like to make a donation to Jana Marie Foundation, that would be fantastic. I'm hoping that Marissa will chime in here for the best and easiest way for folks to do that. So yeah, if you want to go to that website, www.janamarie.com/support, it looks like that is the best place to help support the Jana Marie Foundation, all the great work that they do. If you're just joining us, welcome to one of Jana Marie Foundation's wellness breaks during these very strange times that we find ourselves in. I'm so happy to be here and happy to be invited to participate in a wellness break. My name is Jackie and I am with Paint with Jackie, and we are going to be creating art together. Hi Anya and Evan, I'm so glad you're back. I can't wait to see these finished products. So again, if you're just joining us, please check out our supplies list. If you do not have paint and a canvas, that is totally fine. on Tuesday at Paint with Jackie, we did a live video, and I saw amazing artwork in colored pencils and crayons, and it was great. Oh, Marissa, do you see that? Andrea couldn't get to the donation link. So let's make sure we got access to that donation link for Jana Marie Foundation. Yes, everybody, if you would like to and are willing and able to support the Jana Marie Foundation, give them a little something as a thanks for offering this wellness break, please go to their website, go to their Facebook page. There should be a way to figure out where we can best support them. I know that on their Facebook page, they just posted some sort of fundraiser link where you can throw some money their way to help them out. There we go, janamariefoundation.org/support. If you want to go to that website, that would be the best way to donate to this foundation. And thank you, Jennifer, for the comment. Yes, Jana Marie Foundation does absolutely fantastic work in our community, and anything we can do to support them would be much appreciated. I understand that a major fundraiser that they do was canceled, so they're going to need an extra boost from us. So anything that you can throw their way would be much appreciated and fantastic. Hi, welcome back, Michelle. If you're just joining us, thank you so much for being here for this Jana Marie Foundation wellness break. My name is Jackie, and I am Paint with Jackie, essentially. And we are here once again in central Pennsylvania. It's a cloudy gray day, and we're going to create art together, bring some color and brightness to our day today. Hi, Jeanette. Welcome back. I hope all the family's there. I can't wait to see all these when we're done. So it looks like it's 2:05 right now, so I think we can go ahead and get started. Everyone should have their materials ready, whether you're painting on canvas or you're drawing on paper. Yes, we don't even need paper. Arms and faces can work great. I might have missed part of that conversation, but yes, we can do interpretive dances for this painting. Actually, that would be a great challenge. If anybody out there wants to post a video of them doing a dance interpretation of this painting, I don't know. For some reason Andrea McCloskey and PJ come to mind here, that they could probably do something amazing. Maybe post it on Happy Valley Improv's page for some embodied action of a painting. Anyway, so how about we get started here, guys? So I'm just going to take our little supply list away, and we're going to be working on this little guy today. This was inspired by a painting that we did at the arena for Cheers to Art. I'm not quite sure when. Yes. See, Marissa, yeah, we want to see this video, Andrea. At the arena, we did something like this. So today, I thought we'd do in a different color scheme here, okay? So you can do either color scheme, right? It's totally up to you. This is kind of a fun one where you can play with color however you like. I'm going to do the reddish-purplish one to go with my bluish one that I already have. And again, this is a painting that I chose to do because if you don't have paint, we can make it work with crayons, colored pencils, anything we've got laying around the house. This would be a great drawing with pencils, pens, whatever you got going on. Again, all of us are waiting for that video interpretation, Andrea. So let me just grab my canvas here. So we're gonna start this painting by working on this glow area in the center, okay? So we're going to, I've got a big brush and a little brush here. So hopefully you have something like that happening. If not, we will make it work with whatever we've got going on. I'm gonna start, yes, I will show the blue one again. So there's the blue one. So how about I leave that here for a sec in case anybody wants to take a picture of it or screenshot it so you can reference it. So that's the blue one. This is something that we did together in Central Pennsylvania at the Arena Bar and Grill, where we do our Cheers to Art. So some of you folks might already have this in your garage or wherever you stack your paintings. So I figured we'd add to our blue background, we'd add some dragonflies with a more reddish background. But this is great. This is a great painting. You can kind of choose whatever color scheme you like. Okay, so there's that blue one. Sure, no problem, Michelle. Absolutely. Yeah, have fun with this one, guys. It's your color scheme, your background. Really, whatever color you do back there will be great. Again, having that black sort of pop on top. Again, there's the one that I'll be working on with you guys. All right, so let's get started here. All right, I'm gonna take my bigger brush and I'm going to dip into some white paint here. And I'm gonna start to develop this glow in the middle here. Whoops. All right. So again, I've got my big brush and I'm just kind of swirling white in this upper area. This is where my glow is going to be. The question is always, how big? Well, you can do it as big as you want. This is where our glowy, yellowy center will be. If you want to kind of have a guideline for how big, I'm on an 11 by 14 canvas, and I don't know, it's a bit smaller than a paper plate, the size I'm going for here. And we don't want to be too light with our paint coverage, but we don't want to be too heavy. Because we do want this to dry eventually, right? But we do want to keep it wet to blend our next color. So I'm just kind of having a little too much fun here. Doot, doot, doot. I don't know about you, but one of my favorite parts of watching Bob Ross was the sound the paintbrush made on the canvas. I don't know if it sounds cool on here or not. I hope it does. Okay. So I'm not even gonna bother cleaning my brush because I do wanna get some blend happening. So for my next step, I'm going to dip into a little smidgy smooch of yellow. That's a technical term for just a tiny, tiny bit of paint. When we're painting, we always wanna add color and paint in little smidgy smooches because we can always add more paint to the canvas. It's harder to take it away, right? And I just wanna, maybe if I can hold this up into the light a bit, you can kind of see how big my white splotch is. All right, so there goes my little brush on the floor. Oh, all right. Still got my big brush. It's still got that wet paint on it, that white paint on it, and that's fine. I'm gonna dip into a little smidgy smooch of yellow. That's about a smidgy smooch, okay? Now I'm going to start to form a ring around this white blob that I have here. And so I'm going directly into that white paint that's already there, right? So we can start to see this kind of blendy glow happening, right? And I'm gonna have to pick up another smidgy smooch of yellow
to finish. And I'm just gonna keep working this yellow paint in here. And I'm kind of bringing it more towards the center. And as I bring my brush more towards the center, it's gonna be picking up on more white. And then I can, you know, go towards the center, pick up that white, and then move outwards, kind of blending it in towards the yellow. And then I just kind of go loopy, loopy, roundy, round, just kind of playing with that, those two colors together. All right, I'm gonna pause there to see if anybody needs to catch up, see if anybody has any questions. Oops. I know I shouldn't have started playing with this tripod here. Okay. So, how's everybody doing? I hope we're doing all right. So, a question that usually comes up at this point is, what happens if I don't have a good blend and I want a good blend? That usually happens when we've gotten too harsh with our colors side by side, or maybe paint has already dried so we can't get a good blend going on. So, for example, I'm going to grab a paper plate. Fresh package of paper plate. All right. So something that often happens is people will have, you know, two harsh lines together and they want more of a blend. So I recommend taking whatever it is the lighter color is and just working it more in to the darker color. So in that case, yellow, and just kind of working things back and forth, back and forth, and you can get a blend happening. Okay, that's if the two colors are still wet. If the two colors or one of the colors has dried, it's going to be more difficult to blend. But in that case, what you would want to do is try to find the middle tone of the two colors. So mixing yellow and white together to get just a really light yellow, and you would use that middle tone in the center and try to get a blend going on that way. However, you don't have to get a blend on. Maybe you want some nice sharp rings around our glowing center circle. And that's totally fine, because this is your world, as Bob Ross would say. I believe this is your painting, this is your world, and you can do whatever you like. All right, hopefully everybody's caught up. I'm gonna revisit my glow, but this time I've got a lot more paint on my brush. I still have some white paint on there, and that's fine with me. I don't care if it gets a little blendy. So I've got more yellow paint, and I'm just gonna hit up my outer circle with this. And then as I'm going around and round, I can kind of lightly blend inwards just to make sure I'm maintaining that blend. And if you're using crayons or colored pencils or markers at this point, then yeah, you're probably going to get more of a ring effect. With a colored pencil, you can press harder or lighter with your pencil to get different values, different lightnesses, and you can do more blendy with colored pencils. Pastels and chalks would be good to blend with. But if you're using crayons, those are gonna work too. All right. Now I'm just gonna revisit my yellow ring here, because I want to be able to blend with my
Next color. All right, so for our next trick, I'm going to get a little smidgy smooch of red. Okay, and here's where we really want to make sure that we have the smidgiest of smeechies smooches, because a little red will go a long way. Let's see. For me, that's about all I'm grabbing with the red. Again, I didn't wipe off my brush, because I do want to kind of keep these things blending. And the yellow that's already on the brush is going to help, whatchamacallit, it's going to help tone down that red so we don't go crazy once we put it on our canvas here. All right, so same thing that we did with the yellow and the white, we're going to do with the red and the yellow. So I'm just going to touch the outer edge of my yellow circle and get some blendy. So you might, I'm glad this is happening so I can show you. You might be able to see how I'm getting a little sketchy. It's picking up the, texture of the canvas here. And that's because the paint is drying. And that's fine, but that just means it's gonna be a little bit more difficult to blend. So I might go in and grab some more yellow to help myself out here if I'm really going for that blendy blend. So I'll show you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna dip most of my brush back in the yellow and then a little smidgy smooch at the tip. Okay? So you can kind of see how I've loaded my brush to help me get more of a blend going. So I've got mostly yellow down here and just a little smidgy smooch of red up there, which will enable me to get a blend happening, even though my canvas is drying. Again, I didn't show you before I put it on the canvas, but I had more yellow over here and a little smidgy smooch of red at the tip. So ideally, I'd be doing this much faster, right? Because I wouldn't want that paint to dry. So when I do these on my own, not teaching, I would go through this process much, much more quickly to make sure that my paint's not drying. But when I'm doing a demo or teaching and I have to slow down and make sure everybody's with me, we get these little streakies because it's drying. But you know what? I'm gonna yes and all over this painting. And those of you who are improvisers will know what I'm talking about or have heard of improv. So I'm just gonna yes and this painting. I'm gonna accept what's happening and I'm gonna build onto it and add to it. Y'all have been very quiet, which I hope means that you're just so engrossed and you're doing a great job, and it's not a connection issue, and you're not hearing me anymore, so, or the video has stopped. All right. Oh, James Tierney gave me some hearts, so I guess you can hear me still. All right, I'm gonna pause here to make sure everybody can get caught up. Kim, I know you're the best student. You're the bestest. Oh, that's right. Your favorite color is orange, right? A Met fan. Or are you a Met fan because you like orange, or do you like orange because you're a Met fan, or because of your truck? Which is it? All right. So if you're ready to move on, then our next step is to basically fill the rest of the canvas with red paint. And I'm not going to wash my brush at all. I'm still just going to keep adding paint to my brush. And okay, so you like orange because you're a Mets fan. Got it. Oh, Penelope likes orange too. It is a pretty nice color. So as I'm adding red to the rest of this canvas, I'm not going to go super heavy with it. In the original painting, I did not go super heavy with the red paint. It's going to kind of help give it a softer feel or effect. If you want to go in hot and heavy with the... I can't believe I just said that. If you want to go in heavy with the red paint, that's fine. But in the original painting, I did not. I went kind of really light with the red. In other words, I'm trying to spread out as much of that red as I can before I add more. Don't spill your cup of water like I almost did. Also, don't drink your paint water and don't stick your brush in your mouth. I can't tell you how many times I use the back of my paintbrush like this as like a stamp for, you know, snowflakes or stars, and I forget that I've used the end of the brush. And I stick it in my mouth. It doesn't taste very good. Non-toxic, these acrylic paints are, but, you know, not pleasant. All right, so I am basically... Sorry, Andrea. I'll be more vigilant next time and... telling you about that, those hazards. All right, so I've basically filled up my canvas here with red, and I'm actually gonna keep working now. I don't want this to dry, because I'm gonna hit the corners with blue to kind of transform the corners to a more purpley color. If you have straight purple, you can do that at this point as well, but I'm just gonna use a little smidgy smooch of blue in my corners here. Like this. So again, my red got a little bit dry, so I am going to pick up a little bit of red and blue at the same time on my brush so I can get more of a blend going inwards towards the center. All right, you got it, Nikki. All right, so I'm going to pause there with my first purple corner so we can get folks caught up here. So before I started adding blue to my corners,
all I did was just fill up the rest of my canvas with red. A nice light coat of red. But I did want to move on quickly to the blue, because the red will dry and I won't be able to get my blend on, but we can certainly just add more red once we add the blue together to get that blend of purple happening. Again, as we're taking a little break for everyone to catch up, I want to thank the Jana Marie Foundation for having me here on this wellness break. Please go check out their Facebook page and their website. Consider throwing a couple of dollars their way. They are a great part of our community. They do so much for young people in this area. And I know that one of their big fundraisers got canceled. So as a thank you to them for having this wellness break, check out their, oh, thanks James for posting that link for them. And Marissa can chime in. I think we're doing two more of these paint wellness breaks. One, a week from today and then 2 weeks from today. All right, so I'm going to, great, yes. So we're on for, sorry, responding to comments. I'm going to be doing two more of these paint wellness breaks with Jana Marie Foundation on their Facebook page. So a week from today at 2 o'clock, and then the following Thursday as well at 2 o'clock. So you're joining us for the first of a three-part wellness break series with Paint with Jackie at Jana Marie Foundation. All right, now I'm gonna revisit my three corners here. So by now my red paint has dried. Maybe yours is not dry yet, and that's great. But if you're in the situation like I am where my red paint has dried, I am gonna wanna touch those corners up again so I can get my blue to blend in there. And again, at this point, we're really going smidgy smooch on these corners with the blue. So again, all I did was add more red to my corner so I can get some blue to blend into a purple. I've got the smidgiest of smooches of blue on that brush. I don't even know if you can see it. So just a wee, wee, wee little bit of blue paint there, just to make sure I'm not going crazy. Oh yeah, see that? That shows up pretty well. I am gonna go over that again with red and blue. But see, when I just have a little smidgy smooch, I can control what goes down on that canvas. I forgot. I wanted to show you guys. Check out our guest. It's Bob Ross and his raccoon. These were given to me by a very good friend of mine, Susie. Susie's at Changing Times Hair Designs downtown. She's the owner, and as you can imagine, she's feeling the the brunt of what's been going on, especially her staff there. So I wasn't planning on plugging Changing Times Hair Designs, but here we are. And I, you know, that wasn't part of the deal here. But if you know Susie at Changing Times, she's great. And she gave me this little Bob Ross. I love him. So he's just gonna, he'll be right here for now. Just kind of inspiring us. Okay, so I'm gonna keep on working on my purple corners here. Oh, Bob, I'm gonna have to put you over here. I'll put you over here so you can just watch. There you go. All right, so I've got my bottom corners down here. Oh, sorry, Bob. Ugh, you're just gonna have to go away. I'll be able to see you, but our friends in Facebook land won't be able to see you. All right, so let's get this canvas back where we can see everything. There we go. All right, so I'm gonna get the tippity tops, my top corners. Again, I'm gonna give them a little bit more red so I can blend my little bit of blue there. Oh, right. So when we're done, please post a picture of your finished product on the Jana Marie Foundation event. And if you'd like to also pop in on Paint with Jackie's Facebook page, you could post them there as well. Wonderful. I cannot wait to see this video. That is amazing. I'm so proud of you guys. I can't wait to see that. All right, so once we've done our little corners with blue/purple blending, then we can move on to our black paint, actually. And moving to a brush that you feel good about making fine lines with. Actually, if you have acrylic paint on canvas and you let it dry, a Sharpie marker goes on top of dry acrylic paint. So if you wanted to switch over to a Sharpie marker, that could also work. If the idea of doing fine lines with a big brush is not your jam. So I'm done with my background, and all I'm gonna do is wipe off any excess paint I have on my brush, and then I'm gonna give my brush a nice good clean rinse. All right. How is everybody doing out there? Do we need a minute before we move on to more of our black paint drawing stuff? I'm seeing some thumbs up. I wonder if that means that, yes, we need more time. So actually, while we're waiting, I can kind of demo the dragonfly. Kim's like, there's no need to wait. There's absolutely no need to wait for me. We're just gonna do this, right? So what I can do is demo the how to go about drawing the dragonflies. So you can draw the dragonflies with a small paintbrush. With me right now, I actually don't have the best paintbrush in the world to do small drawing, but I do have a smaller angled brush. So this was the big brush that I was using here, and I do have this one, but it is a little finicky and I can't get quite a great line on it. But I'm gonna do my best. And what I'm gonna do is I can show you the basic steps and shapes of the dragonflies. So you can follow along and add dragonflies wherever you like. These dragonflies are pretty fun because they're basically just a bunch of circles. So what I'm doing right now is I'm just taking a little bit of black paint in my little brush and I'm moving my brush back and forth on my plate. I don't know if you can see this. Back and forth like this. I'm trying to get as fine an edge of a line as I can on those bristles. All right, and now I'm gonna show you basically how to do a dragonfly. So for these dragonflies, all I did was do a small circle for the dragonfly head. There's a small circle for the dragonfly's head, and then a bigger circle for the, well, let's get technical here, the thorax, I think? Head, thorax, PJ, you should know this. Don't they teach you this stuff in school? The head, the thorax, and the abdomen? Is that right? So, the head is a little circle. The body or thorax is a bigger circle. And then for the abdomen, we're just gonna add like a bunch of little loops one after the other. Loop, loop, making loops, doop, 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 doop. Okay, and that's basically the body of the dragonfly. And then from there, we can add wings. And I will go over these again one by one once we get to the actual painting. So for the wings, I'm going to start at the abdomen and I can pull out that top wing. I don't have enough paint on my brush, so I'm getting a little sketchy. Then I can add another big wing over here. What I find helpful is do a Google image search of a dragonfly to really see how the shapes of those wings, because they are quite particular. And then we got a dragonfly. Kapow. In case anybody's doing Sharpie or marker or crayons, I can show you again. So again, we've got a little circle for head, bigger circle for the thorax, and then loops for the body or the abdomen. And then we can pull out little wings. Like so. And then, of course, with a Sharpie, it's easier to add those little veins in their wings here. And you could add veins with the paintbrush, if you've got a nice small paintbrush there. Thanks, Penelope. So we can also add little veins in those wings with the paintbrush. Yeah, so that's a pretty simple way to do a dragonfly. Again, the head is a small circle, thorax is a bigger circle, and then for the abdomen, it's just little loops connected to one another. And then we pull out two sets of wings from the thorax. So for our painting, let's do those dragonflies first, because they're sort of the, I guess, the important part of the painting, right? We like those dragonflies. So we want to be able to put those dragonflies where we want them to be. We don't want to start with the plants first and then you have the plants dictate where the dragonflies go, in other words. So let's place down our dragonflies first. And I hope you didn't just hear my stomach growl. I think I forgot to eat lunch. Can you show drawing the wings again? Absolutely. All right. So the top wings are a bit, absolutely, Michelle. The top wings are a bit longer than the bottom set of wings, right? Let me pull out this quick little dragonfly here. All right, so for the top wing, let's pull out a line like so in between the head and the thorax, and then we'll bring it in. And let's do the same thing on the other side. Pull out a nice long line and then bring that wing in. And then a smaller set underneath. So they're kind of like thin leaves, right? If you can draw leaves, you can draw wings. So they're like long, thin leaves, two on each side. And just like leaves, they have little veins, right? They're like little stained glass windows. So yeah, if you want to think about those wings like long, thin leaves that you might see on a tree or a bush. And what I also recommend, if you have a tablecloth or another scrap piece of paper, then practice those fine lines. Practice first on something else to kind of get a feel for how to draw it, how the paintbrush works, how much paint you need to get it right. So yeah, practicing first on a paper plate or the tablecloth. If you have a plastic table covering, don't paint on your family's tablecloth in the kitchen. Don't do that. Practicing first is helpful to get an idea of how you want to go about it. All right. I hope that helped for your little one, Michelle. Okay. So let's go back to our painting. And in the original, I've got three dragonflies. You can have more, you can have fewer. This is your world. It's up to you. Okay? All right. So I'm going to kind of copy that same formation, having a little guy pointing out that way, another guy pointing out the opposite way, and then sort of this back and forth with those three. But again, because I'm going to do the dragonflies first, I can choose exactly where I want them to be and not worry about them getting in the way of the plants and things. All right. So I'm going to go back into my black paint with my little brush here. Trying to get a really good edge and point here, but these brushes I think are losing their sharpness. Might be time to get some new brushes. All right, so let's put this purpley one's gonna go right here. Little circle. Bigger circle. And these little loopy loops for the body. And you've kind of noticed maybe that when I do the loopy loops for the body, I kind of curve the body. You can do that. You can have a straight body or abdomen. It's up to you. All right, let's put some wings on. Again, they're kind of like thin little leaves. Gosh, does anybody, I'm just remembering, it was the late 90s when dragonflies were like a huge thing. Oh my goodness, and I went to Claire's. And I got a set of dragonfly earrings and a necklace with a dragonfly on it. And it was like the coolest thing. And I think I also had like a long sleeve, tight Lycra shirt with dragonflies all over it. Is anybody remembering this dragonfly thing, like late 90s? I remember. Yes, I think I bought that whole outfit for like a high school dance. Like, I gotta have my dragonfly necklace and my earrings and my dragonfly shirt, and I'm gonna look awesome. Oh my gosh, there's a picture of me standing in this outfit in front of the fireplace, and now I'm set on trying to find it. If I find that picture, I am posting it on Paint with Jackie along with this painting. I had my hair blown out nice and straight. I was rocking my braces and all of the dragonfly accessories. All right, so now I'm gonna add my little veins here. I don't care too much about how perfect these veins are, because they're a lot of it will get covered up by the color that we'll add later. All right, so that's my first dragonfly. I'm gonna add my other dragonfly over here. Again, I'm gonna start with a little circle for the head. Bigger circle for the thorax. And little loopy loops for the abdomen. By the way, if anybody you know is unable to join us here for the live paint, these live videos get automatically saved in the video section of the page. So this video would be available on the video section of the Jana Marie Foundation Facebook page if you want to let other people know, anybody else you know that might enjoy painting these dragonflies but had to miss it, then they can find it on the Jana Marie Foundation page in the video section. And also don't forget to share the Jana Marie Foundation Facebook page and their website. Get people on board to help support them in any way they can. Maybe as a thank you for offering this wellness series, you might consider donating a couple of dollars their way. They do great work for the community. Alrighty. Time for some wings. Yes, Pandora, I'm still listening. Alrighty. Alrighty, how's everybody doing? Yes, those of you who are just joining us, this is a Paint with Jackie wellness break at the Jana Marie Foundation. Happy to have you on this cloudy Thursday as we add some color and fun into our day. All right, I'm going to add my third and final dragonfly over here. Circle for the head. Ooh, that's a little head. Oh, that poor dragonfly. That poor dragonfly. All right, I'm going to give you a bigger head, you poor thing. There we go. Now it's super big and splotchy, and that's okay. All right, so that's my head. I'm gonna add a bigger one for the thorax. And my little loopy loops for my abdomen. Alrighty. You can add antennae and legs if you like. I haven't on this painting, just because I do not trust the thinness of this brush. Yay, Andrea! I bet you are. I can't wait to see these finished products. Again, hopefully you'll share those on the Jana Marie Foundation event page. It's my favorite part. I love seeing everybody's work. It makes me so happy to see everybody's different interpretations, different colors. Welcome, Elaine. Join the fun. All right, so we've got our dragonflies outlined, and we want to let them dry because we're going to put color over them, and we don't want our colors to smudge and get muddied by the black paint. So let's let those dry and we can move on to adding some plants and things, also a technical term, plants and things. So you can use any brush that you like. I'm going to be using both my big brush and little brush. For my big brush, I'm going to use it to get a fine line with the tippity tips of my bristles. And if you look at the original, you can kind of see how the stems are coming from outside the canvas and working their way inwards, right? And that's kind of what I want to do. I want to have these plants coming in towards the center this way. And that helps, if we want to get artsy and technical here, that's going to help our eyes look inwards towards the center, towards our dragonflies, towards our glow, and that kind of brings our gaze into the direction that we want to go. All right, so I'm using my big brush and I'm moving the brush back and forth on my plate. I want to get as nice an edge as I can. Again, I'm going to use the tippity tips of my bristles. I'm not going to press too hard, but I want those bristles to be perpendicular to the canvas. I'm sure Penelope and Anya know perpendicular, or maybe not yet. I don't know. When do we learn about perpendicular? I don't remember. Anyway, so let me move this up here. I'm going to start at the bottom and I'm going to press. Can you see this? I don't know if it's in a good light. Okay, let's do it like this. Let's do it just like that. All right, so I have my brush tippity tips. Those bristles are perpendicular to the canvas and I'm going to pull them up very gently and pull my brush away. See, this brush is just, it's getting a little bit worn. James knows a word. That's great. All right. I'm going to thicken that out at the bottom. Let's try that again. So you can see that I got this little craziness happening. And that's because these brushes are just, I think they've seen better days. Might be time for some new brushes. But I can use, again, the tippity tops. Yeah, I feel better about that one. All right. And I'm basically just going to put, like, these little sticks and things wherever I want. Again, I'm kind of making sure that they're working towards pointing towards the center of our composition here. All right, I'm going to put this down. So yeah, at this point we're just kind of adding sticks and twigs, and I can show you, once all our sticks and twiggy things are down, I can show you how to do the leaves and flowers. Maybe even add just some grassy, just short little grassy strokes. Ooh. All right. I can tell that everybody is doing a fantastic job. I can just feel it. The day doesn't feel gray anymore. We are getting our paint on with Jana Marie Foundation on this wellness break. Like some folks were having trouble finding us on the Jana Marie page. Let's see if we can get them back. Right, so, I think I need more black paint, so I'm just gonna help myself. Alrighty. Alright, so here's where we get to have fun if you've got different kinds of brushes. I like using brushes as like stamps. So you can kind of play around with what your brush does when you just stamp it. And I'll show you what I mean. Where's my plate? Where's my plate? All right, so I've got this little angled brush, and if I just press it, you know, I can kind of see what happens. And I kind of like that as like a leaf that we can add to our little sticks and twigs. So that's what that does. If I rotate the brush so it's at the tiny tip of the brush, I can get a different kind of stamp happening. Get these smaller things. Also good for like leaves. I can also see what my big old brush does as a stamp. It's gonna be much bigger, but same idea, right? So those are good leaves, but probably a little too big for this painting, at least in my opinion. But I can rotate that and just get the corner of it, and maybe I can get an interesting little stamp. So those are kind of fun, little triangles. So yeah, if you've got a bunch of different brushes, test out how they react when you use them as like a little stamp. And that's what I'm gonna do for most of my little leaves and things on this painting. So you can kind of see that I've got some stamp action there. Okay, even these little guys here, that's just using a brush as a stamp, holding it in a certain way. That was sort of a happy accident, as Bob Ross would say. Bob Ross! Bob Ross! Oh, this poor guy. Bob Ross. That's a happy accident right there. Okay, bye. All right, so let's go to our working painting. And I'm gonna use my little brush as a stamper. Like this. I don't know why I did that terrible voice for Bob Ross. He did not sound that way at all. He sounded wonderful. putting some leaves on, just tapping the tippity tips of that little brush there. Almost get like little ferns happening here. Hey, Mel. Mel, I hope you're doing okay with those kiddos at home. Do, 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 do. Kiddos, plural? I don't know. Maybe I'm making things up in my head. I don't know if the second kiddo is there yet. Yes. Alrighty. I'm gonna add some more little stamp leaves over here. I'm just having fun putting leaves wherever I want. Right, I didn't think so. But for a moment, I just imagine you at home with like two kids and a dog and a mat. I'm gonna add some of my little leaves over here. Alright, so I've got those little leaves down there. I'll take a little break to have everybody catch up if you like. I do tend to do my stamping rather quickly. Alright, so I've tried that stamper with my little brush. Now I'm gonna turn my brush so it's just the very wee little corner there that's gonna do the stamping, and that's how I'm gonna try to get this smaller little leaf effect happening. Something like that. Alrighty, how's everybody doing out there? It's so hard for me not to see what you guys are doing, what you guys are up to. It's one of my favorite parts is watching the process of these masterpieces coming together. But I have a feeling y'all are doing a great job out there. So happy to have you with me on this Jana Marie Foundation wellness break. I know I'm feeling a lot better than I was before on this gray day, getting some color in our lives today. So yeah, you can have fun with adding any kinds of leaves and flowers, twigs and branches, whatever you like, whatever you want going on down there in your little meadow or swamp or wherever these dragonflies are flying out of. All right, so in the original painting, I have these little flowers happening down there, and that's still just using my little brush like a little stamp. Let's put that flower here. And I'm kind of pulling the stamp out a bit more. It's a bit more of a stroke. And then adding some down there. But yeah, you can just have fun adding little foliage, some flowers and leaves, wherever you like. Can't wait to see these. Yeah, if you want, please take a photo of your finished product at the end and post it on the Jana Marie Foundation event page. You can also post them at my Facebook page, Paint with Jackie. Love seeing the final photos. So yeah, any way you can get those to me. On Tuesday, people were texting them to me, messaging them to me on Facebook. It was so great. I love, love, love seeing everybody's artwork. And I loved how creative everybody was. I saw we had paintings, we had pencil drawings, crayons, chalk. It was awesome. Awesome to see. All right, so I'm pretty much done with my black paint stuff. I'm gonna wipe off the excess black paint from my brushes. Especially with the black paint, we want to get as much of that black paint off of our brush as possible. We don't want to dirty our water too much. So I'm just wiping off as much paint as I can. All right, I'm going to give those brushes a nice good clean rinse. Alrighty. I'm just going to be using my little brush for the color, adding the color to our dragonflies. Alrighty. Let's see, did you find us? Just making sure this person has found us on our video here. I'm not sure. Let's see. Ah, okay. So I hope, Ashley, I hope you found us. All right. So, guys, the original, I had like a green dragonfly, a light blue dragonfly, and a purpley blue dragonfly down here. Here's where we get to have fun. We get to make, you know, whatever color dragonflies we want. And you know what? We don't have to make them all, you know, one solid color. And this blue one, I had like a yellow and red one over here. This one had a lavender body and pink wings. So we get to have fun. And, you know, make whatever color we want. Some rainbow dragonflies. So I'm going to mix up that green for my green dragonfly, because I do like me a green dragonfly. Take some blue and some yellow to get some green happening here. And my green one is going to go right here. Ooh, I like that green. Sometimes you just have a good green. Now that reminded me of I did a paint party for a group of Cub Scouts. And our first step in the painting that we did with the Cub Scouts was just painting the whole canvas blue. And it was literally just this same blue paint that I have here. And gosh, how old was this kid? I'm so bad at judging ages. He could have been 4 or 12. I don't know. But it was, I'm guessing he was probably around 8. And as soon as he started painting with the blue paint on the canvas, he goes, "That is a great blue. Look at that blue." It made my heart so happy. Colors make us happy, I think. A good paint color makes me happy. All right. Here we go. Ooh, those look kind of more bluish than the other ones, but that's totally cool. So yeah, I'm just using my little brush, mixing up colors, and I'm just filling in these little dragonflies. And it doesn't have to be perfect. I'm kind of getting outside of the lines here, but that's totally fine. And the black of the veins should be able to come through the paint that you're putting over it. So I wouldn't go crazy about trying to fill in like each individual section of wing. I just kind of go right over top of everything. All right, I'm just rinsing my brush, and I'm gonna make a light blue. So getting just a little bit of blue here, grab a little bit of white. I think I want it lighter than that. All right, let's give this dragonfly some blue color. Ooh, we're getting a little bit out of the lines here. It's okay, it kind of shows that the dragonfly is in motion. That's what I'm going to say. All right. I'm going to take advantage of that light blue in my brush, and if I just tap into a little smidgy of red, I can turn that into a lavendery purple. So let's. Oh, I think I want that a bit more red. Oh, I'm so glad, Kathleen. Thank you so much for being here. Please take a picture of your final masterpiece and put it on the Jana Marie Foundation page. We'd love to see it. Makes me so happy. Thanks for being here with us, Kathleen. Whoops! I got so excited. I keep knocking into the stand here. Alrighty. I'm going to add I've added a little bit more white to that for the wings, just cause why not? This is a fun one, right guys? I kind of like that it's a little bit dry and sketchy for some reason. I'm actually going to extend that wing out a little bit more. Why not? Why not? All right. Let's see. I think I'm going to add a little bit more red to that blue. Just give a little swoop on the top here, just for funsies. Yeah, you can have fun with those dragonflies. Really, sort of anything goes with those dragonflies in terms of color. Oh no, I forgot to paint the abdomen of my blue one. He's just hanging out there naked. I better put some clothes on that one over there. All right, I'm just rinsing my brush. I'm gonna mix some light blue so I can get the abdomen of that blue one covered. All right. There we go. All right, guys. Once those dragonflies are filled in with color, we are ready to stick a fork in this one. This was a fun one, huh? I hope you guys enjoyed painting along with me here at the Wellness Break with Jana Marie Foundation. Again, as a thank you to Jana Marie Foundation for having these wellness breaks. If you want to check out their Facebook page, go to their website, and if you can, maybe donate a few dollars for them. I know that they had a major fundraiser get canceled, so any help we can throw their way would be much appreciated. Jana Marie Foundation does amazing work for young people in this community. They do a ton of programming, and it's really great if we can help them out. Oh, thank you, Cheryl and Cameron. Thanks for being here. Thank you, Sherry. So we'll just be hanging out here for a minute or so if you still need to see the painting as you're finishing up. But again, thank you so much for being here. I had so much fun adding some color on this cloudy Thursday. Thank you so much to Jana Marie Foundation for having me. I will be back next week, so next Thursday, same time, same place. We'll do another painting together. Tell your friends and family, anybody who you think would enjoy a little art break in their day. Just share the link, share the Facebook page with them, and I'll see you same time, same place next Thursday. Again, my name is Jackie. This is Paint with Jackie for a wellness break with Jana Marie Foundation. Thanks again, and I'll see you next time.